Ever edit photos that look great on your phone only to find they appear too dark, too bright, or have odd color tints on other screens? It's a common issue, often because we lack an objective way to judge exposure and color balance. Today we are tackling this with a key tool in Lightroom Mobile, the RGB Histogram. It might look different in various apps, but the fundamentals are the same. Let's get started. So, what are these three histograms? Red, green, and blue. Each graph shows the brightness values for its specific color channel. The horizontal x-axis for each represents tones from pure black on the far left through darker shades, mid-tones, brighter shades, and finally, full intensity of that color on the far right. The vertical y-axis shows how many pixels have that specific brightness for that particular color. A tall peak in the red channel, for instance, means many pixels have that intensity of red. To judge overall brightness, look at all three RGB channels together. If all are pushed left, the image is generally underexposed. If all are right, it's overexposed. Crucially, these individual channels instantly reveal color balance. If the blue channel is significantly to the right of red and green, your image likely has a blue color cast. A critical role of the histogram is avoiding clipping, where detail is lost because areas are pure black or a color channel is maxed out. If all three channels are maxed right, you get pure white. If just one channel clips, that color detail is gone. Lightroom Mobile has clipping warnings, usually seen by sliding with two fingers on the sliders in the light panel. Pure black areas get a blue overlay. Areas where any channel clips high show red. These warnings are objective, unlike our adaptable eyes or variable screens. Understanding RGB histogram patterns is key. If all three red, green, and blue channels are pushed heavily left, your photo is likely underexposed overall. You'd probably see blue shadow clipping. Conversely, if all three channels are bunched up on the right, crashing against the wall, the photo is likely overexposed. The red highlight clipping overlay would be very active where all three channels are blown out. If all three channels show a dominant peak in the middle with little at the ends, it often signifies a low contrast image which might look flat or hazy. Significant separation between the red, green, and blue channels is a strong indicator of a color cast. For example, a blue channel shifted far right compared to red and green means a blue tint. In a high contrast scene, each RGB channel might be spread wide, possibly with peaks at both ends. The challenge is balancing these without losing detail or color fidelity in highlights or shadows. Remember, the ideal distribution isn't one size fits all. It depends on your photo and creative intent. Now, let's get practical. The RGB histograms and Lightroom Mobile's light panel sliders are your command center. The histograms diagnose and the light panel adjusts. Global sliders like exposure, contrast, highlights, shadows, whites and blacks generally affect all three RGB channels together, shifting their overall position and spread. For an underexposed photo, all three RGB histograms will be left shifted. I will increase exposure, watching all three graphs shift right. If shadows still lack detail across channels, I will gently lift the shadow slider, seeing the left side of all three histograms rise. Throughout, I am checking the blue shadow clipping overlay. With an overexposed photo where all RGB channels are jammed right, I will decrease exposure. The graph shift left. If highlights are still blown, the highlight slider is vital. Pulling this down targets the brightest areas in all channels. Watch the right edges of the RGB histograms pull back. Then adjust whites if needed. For a flat image with RGB histograms bunched in the middle, we need to stretch them. I might start with contrast. Then to define the tonal range, I'll carefully increase whites, pushing the right side of the RGB histograms towards the edge, and decrease blacks, pushing the left sides towards pure black. This adds pop and depth. If your RGB histograms are clearly separated, indicating a color cast, example the blue channel is way off from red and green, your main correction will be in the color panel using white balance, temperature and tint sliders. You would adjust these to align the RGB histograms more closely for a neutral look. While the light panel primarily affects tone, being aware of color cast seen in the RGB histograms is important because tonal adjustments will apply to these already misaligned channels. Fixing significant color cast first is often a good idea before major tonal work. In high contrast scenes where each channel is spread wide, it's a balancing act. You might lower highlights to save detail in brighter parts of each channel, then raise shadows to reveal detail in darker parts, always watching your clipping overlays for each color. The exposure slider helps find the overall balance. You're trying to manage all three channels to retain as much information as possible or make a deliberate creative choice. Remember, the RGB histograms are technical guides, not artistic dictators. Your creative vision is paramount. For instance, if you're creating a silhouette, you want large portions of your subject to be pure black across all three channels. So the histograms will be heavily skewed left, and that's perfect for the style. Similarly, for a bright, high-key image, all three channels will naturally be pushed to the right. A dark, moody, low-key shot will show all RGB channels dominated by shadows. If you're applying a specific color grade, like a strong teal and orange effect, your red, green, and blue channels will be intentionally separated and shaped to achieve that mood. Understanding the RGB histograms allows you to make these creative choices with confidence and precision. So to recap, the RGB histograms in Lightroom Mobile are your objective tools for understanding your photo's tonal range and color balance, channel by channel. They help you spot and prevent clipped shadows and blown out highlights in any red, green or blue channel, preserving maximum detail. Use them dynamically with the light panel sliders for informed exposure and contrast adjustments, and be mindful of how they signal color balance issues. But always let your creative intent lead. My challenge to you: for your next few edits, consciously observe all three RGB histograms before making adjustments. What do they tell you about brightness and color? Then watch how they change as you work. This practice will significantly boost your editing intuition. If this guide to the RGB histogram helped you, please give this video a thumbs up and ask any questions in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe for more editing tips. Thanks for watching and happy editing!